Welcome back, everybody. I'm your host, Storm, and today I'm playing Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. I tried to stream this before, but that wasn't working. Ran into a lot of issues trying to stream it. I have no idea what was going on with my equipment. I never do. But I can still just do a standard Let's Play of it, so that's what I'm going to do here. Now, when I was trying to stream it before, I was playing with a male soldier. So I'm just going to go back and try and do what I did before. There we go. I like this guy the best. I like that scar right there on this face. I'm just going to make every attribute as even as possible. Because that's what I like to do. I mean, even though he's a soldier, so his physical attributes should be pretty good. I still want... Oh, that's it. Hold on. Security is used to access electronic locking devices. Once a character invests points in this skill, it becomes one of the default options on targeted doors and containers. Security spikes can grant a bonus to the skill, and an inventory will also appear as a default option on targeted doors and containers. Characters with no points invested cannot attempt to use this skill. There's also repair, demolition, computer. Computer use allows a character to slice computer programs using disposable logic RAMs called computer spikes. A character might disable gun turrets or flood a patrol area with more complicated tasks requiring more spikes. A high rank in this skill reduces the number of spikes required by 1 to a minimum of 1 for every 4 points total, including attribute score modifiers. Yes, I do want that. And also, one skill. Okay, so we'll go with that. I'll put 1 into empathy because empathy helps with persuade, awareness, and treat injury. Gale Jassara. Oh, Jassara. Yeah, I'm not doing that. Trying to make this as much like that stream I tried to do before. So this is what I do. Zane Lightyear. You know, like Buzz Lightyear. Whatever. It doesn't matter. Anyway, let's go. A long time ago. In a galaxy far, far away. Did anyone else see The Rise of Skywalker recently? I saw it. Star Wars, Knights of the Old Republic. 4,000 years before the rise of the Galactic Empire, The Republic verges on collapse. Darth Malak, last surviving apprentice of the Dark Lord Revan, has unleashed an invincible Sith armada upon an unsuspecting galaxy. Crushing all resistance, Malak's war of conquest has left the Jedi Order scattered and vulnerable as countless knights fall in battle, and many more swear allegiance to the new Sith Master. In the skies above the Outer Rim world of Terrace, a Jedi battle fleet engages the forces of Darth Malak in a desperate effort to halt the Sith's galactic domination. Alright, let's see how this turns out. The only thing I've always loved about Star Wars is, for the most part, they have all had this opening crawl here, which... I mean, the opening crawl did not originate with Star Wars. The idea of an opening crawl wasn't Star Wars' invention, but it's so iconic and it fits Star Wars so well. You know, they may have well have invented it. Oh no, Sith! So anyway, I saw The Rise of Skywalker, and personally, I think it was better than the first two were, but not by a lot. And here's our character waking up in the middle of this of all this terror.
We've been ambushed by a Sith battle fleet. The Endar Spire is under attack. Hurry up, we don't have much time.
Why is there an echo? Hold on. Sorry about that. Who are you?
I'm Trask Ulgo, ensign with the Republic Fleet. I'm your bunkmate here on the Endar Spire. We work opposite shifts. I guess that's why you haven't seen me before.
Now, I guess so.
We have to find Bastila. We have to make sure she makes it off the ship alive.
Who's Bastila?
Bastila is the commanding officer on the Endar Spire. Well, not an officer, really. But she's the one in charge of this mission. One of our primary duties is to guarantee her survival in the event of an enemy attack. You swore an oath just like everyone else on this mission. Now it's time to make good on that oath.
Did I? I don't remember doing that.
Elite combat training, tops in your class. It's no wonder you were handpicked for this mission. Word is the officers haven't seen a recruit with your kind of potential in 20 years. But all that potential doesn't mean a thing if you can't deliver when it counts. We're soldiers. We're trained for combat. Bastila is going to need men and women like us at her side during this attack.
I don't think I'm a soldier. Oath or no oath, I meant to escape pause, because honestly, I don't know what the fuck is going on here.
Don't be stupid. You won't stand a chance against the Sith by yourself. We gotta stick together if you want to make it out of this alive. So hurry up and grab your gear. You need to suit up so we can get out of here.
We're gonna get my equipment.
Use the right thumbstick to control the camera, and the left thumbstick to move towards your footlocker. Press the A button to open your locker once it is targeted, or you can pull the left and right triggers to cycle between targets until the footlocker is highlighted. Then press the A button to open it.
Okay, I know how to do all that stuff already. I just said we're gonna get my equipment just because it seemed more natural for conversation. And also, real quick, what is this left stick and right stick you're talking about? What do you mean A button? Hmm? Give me all this stuff. No experience points just for doing that. Clothing. Blaster. That's it, I think. Looks so weird. I was always a scoundrel whenever I played, because I felt that like the guile and general intelligence of a scoundrel was kind of better, because I wanted to have...
Okay, let's move out. We should stick together. You'll have more success with a party than on your own.
I basically wanted to have, the guile in order to persuade people to do what I wanted them to.
Because of the attack, this room is in lockdown. But don't worry, I've got the override codes. You'll have to use me to unlock the door.
Okay. I believe, wait, yeah, there we go.
Now that the door is open, you better take the lead again.
All right, let's go.
This is Carthel Nassi. The Sith are threatening to overrun our position. We can't hold out long against their firepower. All hands to the bridge.
That was Carth contacting us on our portable communicators. He's one of the Republic's best pilots. He's seen more combat than the rest of the Endar Spire's crew put together. If he says things are bad, you better believe him. We have to get to the bridge to help defend Bastila. There's a map of the Endar Spire and a copy of Karth's message in your electronic journal, just in case we get separated.
All right, let's go. Oh, wait, I think I need these him.
For the Republic?
I don't know, man. These Empire guys seem kind of cool. You sure you don't want to join up with them? I mean, that armor is pretty cool. Jesus. Oh, there goes that little droid. Yeah, this guy, because he's closer. Ugh, why are you missing so much? There we go. Frag grenade. Okay. You know, I shouldn't be surprised that a Sith would kill one of his own. Oh, will you get closer, you idiot? You almost got him. Jeez, why are you shooting the floor so much? God damn it. Okay, great. Open this. 26 credits. 12 credits? You know, I wasn't paying attention. I'm just opening stuff as I get to it. Looting is fun.
It's a dark Jedi. This light is too much for us. We better stay back. All we do is get in the way.
You know, it's simply animated, but I really do like this fight right here.
Jedi accompanying Bastila. Damn, they could have used her help.
Well, I'll say it again, man. These Sith guys, they seem kind of cool. You sure you don't want to join up with them? Oh, shit. There we go. Thank you, Master Jedi. I appreciate the supplies. This is the bridge.
The bridge is just beyond that door. You better equip your melee weapon. There isn't much room on the bridge, and it's suicide to use a blaster in close quarters. I should equip a melee weapon, too. Either that, or I'll have to stay back and use my blaster.
Well, they have lightsabers.
Your melee weapon is made using the Cortosis weave. It's strong enough to stand up against anything, even a lightsaber.
You say that, but I don't know. You can dual wield in the game, but in a very clever way to kind of avoid overpowering you. If you dual wield, then you will your accuracy goes down a lot. And I think your actual attack power is either just your accuracy or your attack power goes down. It's one or the other. But it's kind of a smart thing to do that, I think. There is a way to offset the, who cares about you? There is a way to, take a short sword if you want it so badly. There's a way to offset the damage, the accuracy reduction, but, that's, you have to level up and everything to do that. Right now, I'm in the very center between light and darkness. And so is Trask. I guess, but who cares? Wait, come. No. Okay, back to me. Back to me now. Yeah, this guy. Seems ridiculous to me, though. There's not a lot of room, so we should use a melee weapon. You have to swing your arms around to use a melee weapon. You realize that, right? Come on now. There we go.
must have retreated to the escape pods. We better head that way, too. The Sith want Bastila alive, but once she's off the ship, there's nothing stopping them from blasting the Endar Spire into galactic dust.
Well, let's go stop them then, I guess. Let me put one into a computer. Okay, that needs 2 points to go up again. I can put more into persuade. I don't want to do that. Treat injury. Isn't there a way I can just bank these points? Treat injury, I guess. Can I? No. I need 4. Okay. Two weapon fighting. I'll put that in. And so now I'm dual wielding. Is there anything here? No? Okay, well, let's keep going.
Escape pods. Go.
Isn't that Bandon? All right. Well, spoiler alert. That guy's dead. Which way? Which way? This way. It loads so quickly.
This is Carthel Nassi on your personal communicator. I'm tracking your position through the Endar Spire's life support systems. Bastila's escape pod is away. You're the last surviving crew member on the Endar Spire. Now, I can't wait for you much longer. You have to get to the escape pods.
All right, well, I'm going. I'm coming. Frag grenade. Man, I'm so powerful, my grenade actually went through the wall there. That's amazing. Let's go. I mean, these are really well animated. I love these the choreography here. Don't heal yourself. There we go. Well, let's see what I can do here. How many do I have? 0. Damn it. Fuck. Let me see. Because last time I did this, I had enough, didn't I? Okay, there we go. And it's computer parts too. Alright. Let's try this again. That's all of them dead. Sorry, droid. I don't want to use you. Vibroblade. Vibroblade prototype. Physical damage 1 to 10. Physical bonus plus 1. Physical critical threat 19 to 20 times 2. And then the longsword. That's better to keep the longsword, it looks like. Oh. Alright, well.
You've made it just in time. There's only one active escape pod left. Come on, we can hide out on the planet below.
How do I know I can trust you?
I'm the soldier with the Republic, like you. We're the last two crew members left in the Ender Spire. Bastila's escape pod's already gone, so there's no reason for us to stick around here and get shot by the Sith. Now, come on, there'll be time for questions later.
All right, fine, let's go. This is the last escape pod and your only hope of survival. Yeah, I get that. Let's go. Interesting.
Good to see you up instead of thrashing about in your sleep. You must have been having one hell of a nightmare. I was wondering if you were ever going to wake up. I'm Karth, one of the Republic soldiers from the Endar Spire. I was with you in the escape pod. Do you remember?
I had a strange dream, like a vision or something. Right, I'm Zane Light. Yeah, by the way, how do we get here? Karth, on the communicator. I remember. Where am I? How do I get here?
I've been slipping in and out of consciousness for a couple of days now, so I imagine you're pretty confused about things. Try not to worry. We're safe. At least for the moment. We're in an abandoned apartment on the planet of Terrace. You were banged up pretty bad when our escape pod crashed, but luckily I wasn't seriously hurt. I was able to drag you away from our crash site.
Look, I think so worrying about me.
By the time the Sith arrived, the scene, we were long gone.
The Sith? I can show you my life. Thanks. So we're just going to wait here for the public to rescue us?
You don't have to thank me. I've never abandoned anyone on a mission, and I'm not about to start now. Besides, I'm gonna need your help. Terrace is under Sith control. Their fleet is orbiting the planet, they've declared martial law, and they've imposed a planet-wide quarantine. But I've been in worse spots. I saw on your service records that you understand a remarkable number of alien languages. That's pretty rare in a loyal crew. But it should come in handy while we're stranded on a foreign world. There is no way the Republic will be able to get anyone through the Sith blockade to help us. If we're gonna find Bastila and get off this planet, we can't rely on anybody but ourselves.
Why is it so important to find Bastila?
That smack to your head did more damage than I thought. Bastila's a Jedi. She was with the strike team that killed Darth Revan, Malak's Sith master. Bastila's the key to the whole Republic war effort. The Sith must have found out that she was on the Ender Spire and set an ambush for us in this system. I believe Bastila was on one of the escape pods that crashed down here in Terrace. For the sake of the Republic war effort, we have to try and find her.
How can one person, even a Jedi, be so important? If Bastila is a Jedi, she can probably look after herself. How do you even know Bastila's still alive? Forget it, I'm not risking my life to try and save her. Any idea where we should start looking for Bastila?
Bastila is no ordinary Jedi. She has a rare gift the Jedi call battle meditation. Bastila's,
which is totally not a gameplay mechanic.
And make her enemies lose their will to fight. Often that's all it takes to tip the balance in a battle. Of course, there are limits to what she can do, but from what I understand of her ability, it requires great concentration and focus to maintain her battle meditation. The attack on the Endar Spire happened so fast, she never had a chance to use her battle meditation. Like us, she barely got out alive.
I believe Leia could also use battle meditation. If Bastila's a Jedi, she might look after herself.
Bastila's gonna need our help. Many of Darth Malak's followers can use the dark side of the Force, and the Sith have already killed more than their share of Jedi in this war.
Alright, well, good point.
For a couple of common soldiers like us, and if we're careful, We can move about the planet without attracting notice. A luxury Bastila won't have. She's gonna have half the Sith fleet looking for her. They know how important she is to the war effort. The whole planet's under quarantine. No ships can land or take off. So, if Bastila's gonna escape Terrace, she's gonna need our help. And we'll probably need hers.
Let's see. Any idea we should start looking for Bastila? What's in this for me if I help you out? I think I'll take my chances on my own. If it means getting off this planet, I guess I can find Bastila. Well, any idea where we're still looking?
While you were out, I did some scouting around. There are reports of a couple of skate pods crashing down into the Undercity. It's probably a good place to start. But the Undercity's a dangerous place. I don't want to go there unprepared, and it won't do Bastila any good if we go and get ourselves killed.
I want to ask some questions.
I'll tell you whatever I can, though I don't know how much help it'll be.
What do you know about Malak and the Sith?
Everything I know about Malak is pretty much common knowledge. He escaped the trap that killed Darth Revan, his Sith master. With Revan's death, Malak became the new Dark Lord. It's obvious that Malak's a ruthless tyrant who'll crush anyone who stands in his way, just like Revan was. Experience has shown that the Sith won't stop until the Republic lies in ruins. Malak
and that's
Sith
true.
Don't respect anything except raw, brutal power. It's hard to imagine how someone who used to be a Jedi could become such a monster.
A Jedi? What do you mean? Of course, I already know what he means. I played this through this game at least once before.
Malak and Revan were once both part of the Jedi Order, but they were young and headstrong, and against the wishes of the Council, they went to battle the Mandalorians on the Outer Rim. Something happened out there. Something corrupted them and drew them over to the dark side. Or maybe there was something rotten inside them all along. I don't know. They formed an army of ex-Republic soldiers and Jedi who'd fallen to the dark side, with Revan at their head. Until Revan was killed by Bastila's Jedi strike team. But even that didn't slow the Sith down. Malak just stepped in and assumed Revan's role. He took control of the Sith Armada and resumed the bloody conquest of the Outer Worlds.
It probably shouldn't be too surprising, honestly, that despite the fact that Malak is the main villain of the game, people still like... I mean, like in the actual real life fandom, the Star Wars fandom, people... still like revere Revan far more than Malak, which it doesn't surprise me honestly. If you play through the game, you'll understand why. Let's see. Don't worry, we'll find a way to stop the Sith. Sounds like Malak and the Sith have the right idea. Jesus. The sooner we start looking for Bastila, the sooner we find her. Let's go. Okay, I want to ask you something else.
I'll tell you whatever I can.
What can you tell me about the planet we're on?
Taurus was once a magnificent planet-wide metropolis of towering skyscrapers. That was a long time ago. The upper city where the rich citizens live is still pretty safe. If it wasn't for the Sith occupation and the planet-wide quarantine, it might not even be a bad place to live. But farther down, things have degenerated. The lower city is nothing but a slum overrun by swoop-bike gangs waging a never-ending war for control. And the undercity is... The lowest level of Terrace is a wasteland overrun by Rakghouls, mindless, diseased mutants that attack on sight. I've already entered all this info into your data pad journal.
I'd like to know more about you, Karth.
I understand why you want to know more about me. I kind of get the feeling we'll be spending a lot of time together over the next while. But this isn't really the best time for long introductions. We should stay focused on the task at hand. There'll be a time for that later.
I guess that's it. The sooner we start looking for Bastila, the sooner we find her. Let's go.
Good idea. We can use this abandoned apartment as a base. We can probably get some equipment and supplies here in the upper city. Just remember to keep a low profile. I've heard some grim stories about the Dark Jedi interrogation techniques. They say the Force can do terrible things to a mind. It can wipe away your memories and destroy your very identity. But I figure if we don't do anything stupid, we should be okay. I mean, after all, they're looking for Bastila. Not a couple of grunts like us. All right, soldier, let's move out.
Don't tell me what to do. Why does that lock have a health bar? This is it. Workbench. Throughout the game, you'll find weapons and armor that are marked as upgradable. These items can be improved by the addition of an upgrade item. With upgrade items, you can use this workbench to construct new, more powerful versions of upgradable ranged weapons, melee weapons, lightsabers, and armor. Use the workbench now. Oh, I can actually upgrade this? I don't have any necessary parts. Oh wait, I do actually have something. Okay, what is this for? Plus, all right, fine. Better than nothing, I guess. Well, good first intro for this game. It really is a fun game. I wish I could have streamed it. I'll try and work on that. We'll see what happens next. But until then, I'll talk to you guys later.